Previously, on any given day, a stroll across the Cherereno market here in Gulu would usually inform one that the red colored groundnuts are the most consumed peanuts in the city. But today, as I interact with the traders here, I am informed that the preferred red groundnuts, also known as the red beauty groundnuts, or simply as the serenad, have become very scarce in the local market.
Generally, the prices for gin this year is quite expensive. It affects us badly. First of all, we have very little cup. For you to buy 10 tons, which is the capacity of a truck, you need almost 60 to 70 million. And majority, we don't have that cash.
And due to the current scarcity, the prices have almost doubled. A few months ago, a kilogram of unshelled groundnuts was selling at 1,600 shillings. But it is now selling at 3,500 shillings, while a kilogram of shelled red groundnuts are now selling at 8,000 shillings, which is an increase of 3,000 shillings.
We are consuming genus that is coming from right from Tanzania, comes from Mutukula, and then reaches here very expensively because the cost comes to revenue, transport, all this, it raises the prices.
Simon Olwen sits under the veranda. His eyes are darting left and right. Probably, he is waiting for customers. He explains to me that the traders are now spending a lot of money to import the white groundnuts from Tanzania.
From Mutukula, we pay around 2 million to ferry 12 tons to Gulu. And then those who bring from right from Kahama, deep in Tanzania, they tell us they can hire a full lorry. A full lorry capacity of 30 tons, about to reach maybe Gulu can be up to 8 to 10 million. And then that affects the prices so much.
Furthermore, due to the high costs involved, some traders have opted to purchase the mixed white and red groundnuts from the West Nile city of Arua.
Arua, we are buying from Tanzania. Now we are selling the groundnut at 8,000, 7,500, 7,000, which is expensive, whereby people are complaining a lot. That's the challenge we are having.
The businesswoman who has just been speaking to us is Florence Adong. Her produce store is located on the Paliage Ring Road in Gulu City. She attributes the current scarcity of groundnuts to the low harvest in the previous season.
From TZ, we are having the white one here. It's white. Eh? And this one is from Arua. It's mixed with white. And this, when you are seeing pure red like this, is from here. So getting this one is expensive now. Very difficult.
Next to her store are women whose livelihoods depend on sorting the imported groundnuts. It is a tedious job that they do with a smile.
But they come when it has too much dirt in them. But of course, the traders, they want us to clean them very nice. And you find that they pay us only 2,000 per benson. So the traders, those who are selling, they give us the work also, because for us also, we want our children to eat.
Akelo Nancy is their team leader. Today here at the Cherereno market, as they sit on the paved walkways, even the sound of the passing vehicles cannot drown out their laughter. It looks like they are happy workers. But behind that laughter is underlying fear for their own health.
Come here very early in the morning. You begin sorting these genus. Maybe in the evening it's fine when you've sorted only like 2 bensons in a day. But now that one even cannot buy food. You also sit for long. We are also getting problems with our back pain. And sometimes even you fail to get money for buying even a near painkiller so that you swallow.
But unfortunately, Simon Olwen explains that the groundnuts have become less profitable as the peanuts are imported when they are wet.
Then again, this thing reaches here when it is still wet. The moisture content is still high. We have to spread in the sun. It cuts kilos. Eh? And then as you put in the sun, it changes colors. When you're buying from there, it reaches when it's still bright, shiny. But after putting in the sun, it changes color, become brownish. And then it is hard to convince customers.
And despite it being the planting season here in northern Uganda, the traders believe that consumers do not have enough money to spend and are now buying alternatives to the famous red beauty groundnuts.
We are encouraging the farmer, at least, please, with the rain we are receiving, let's work hard. We should not misuse the rain, we should not misuse the land, but let's concentrate on cultivation.
As the chairperson of the Cherereno Produce Dealers, Okelo Cosmas is also calling on business people who could be hoarding the groundnuts to open their stores before it is too late.
My fellow produce dealer, whoever is keeping the granules, I mean, please bring it out, because if you continue keeping, you are also making it harder for the farmer to get the seeds, and you are making it also harder for the people for the survival. And any time the price might even come down because of the business. Now people are free to bring things from outside the country, therefore it will be difficult for you to sell your produce or granite which you are still owning.
The regions of Acholi, Lango, Teso and the West Nile consume a lot of groundnuts, which are usually roasted and pounded into a paste commonly known as Odi, which is further mixed in meals such as roasted beef and fish. Therefore, the current scarcity of this delicious legume is surely something to think about. I have been your host, Joseph Omagor.